Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back. My name is Drago, and welcome to my Dark Souls 3 Platinum Trophy Guide. In today's episode, we're gonna go ahead and continue walking through the Profane Capital. We're gonna touch base and finish off the remains of Irithyll Dungeon as well, simply because we still need to free Carla, the Pyromancer. So I'm gonna start with that. First of all, if you guys remember, that is the area that had a lot of those annoying jailers in it. So I'm gonna play it safe, and I'm gonna go ahead and upgrade my longbow first. And I'm gonna use it to pull those enemies kind of away, so that way I don't have to worry much about them. Kill them off one by one. Let's see here, I got a bunch of souls that I can use. And in today's episode, I'm just planning to go ahead and finish Profane Capital, and maybe I'll squeeze in the Dancer of the Boreal Valley boss fight here as well. Oh damn, that was a lot of souls. I probably shouldn't have used them all up, but whatever. Okay, so I need to purchase some more large Titanite shards. Since I've picked up the Easterner's Ashes in Anor Londo, I can do so from the Shrine Maiden. So I'm gonna go ahead and grab those and get my longbow to plus 6. That's probably the best option for me right now. If you have the regular Arbalest or Knight's crossbow, that seems to work pretty well as well. And I'm also gonna go ahead and purchase some arrows. I will need large arrows, I believe. And now that I've done that, let's go ahead and travel to Irithyll Dungeon. Let's see, do I have any more undead bone shards? I do not. So first we're gonna travel to Irithyll Dungeon. We've basically cleared off that whole area, picked up all the items. The only thing that we still need to get is Carla and kind of the items surrounding her area. There is a ring there as well. So we're gonna go ahead and start by completing that portion first. Forgot it takes 4 hits to kill him in this build. I've actually been playing, prior to playing back on this character, I was playing a little bit on my luck build using the Unreal Straight Sword, which by the way is awesome sauce, I do have to say. I like it a lot, to be honest with you. Unreal Straight Sword, if you can get your hands on it, really good weapon, especially if you are leveling up luck and faith. It deals quite a bit of damage. So I've been liking it a lot. I have that sword at plus, I want to say plus 4 currently, and it deals like 320 damage with 32 luck and 16 faith, and I started off as a cleric, so I can't say enough good things about it. I got that character up to the same part which this character is on, so I am just finishing up the Irithyll Dungeon and Profane Capital, and I like it a lot. Like I said, you know, there aren't enough good things that I can say about it. Okay, so now that we get here, you will see this general procession here of all the jailers. They're kind of just hanging out here, so what you want to do is you want to lure them off one by one. Again, you know, a longbow or a crossbow is perfect for this. You definitely don't want to run there guns blazing, otherwise they're just going to suck up your health. Thank you. close one. But yeah, if you kind of just stand in the doorway, you should not have too many problems with these guys. Also, if you have the Hawk Ring, go ahead and put it on. It will come in handy for this part. Just because it will give you some extended damage at range. Yeah, and I think I'm just aggroing all of them. Could be bad news here if they all come at me. One by one, though, it's not too bad because you can just R1 them to death. And I almost took, I think I took most of them out. There's probably like two of them left. And bam, there she goes. That was the last one in this area, so now I can kind of just explore this middle room without too many interruptions. Pick up Alva's armor in the corner here, and there's an ember. There's also going to be a ring for us to pick up in this room as well. Another ember. There is still one of those jailers alive here, right by Carla's cell, so I'm going to go ahead and quickly dispatch her. And I don't know if you guys remember, but in the previous video, I've told you to stay away from the cell room. And that's mainly because there's this hollow body that will let out a scream if you pick up this item. And this is going to be Dust Crown Ring. But it will let out a scream. And if you haven't killed the jailers, they will all come pouring into this room. So, could be bad news. So, I suggest getting this after you've cleared the area out of the jailers. And now you can use Jailer's key ring to unlock Carla's cell. So let's go ahead and talk to Carla. She's a callback to Yuria from Demon
I
Souls.
hope you don't look for
Her
me.
outfit looks almost exactly the same.
Good to know that a skinny little heretic can still turn heads. Accept my apologies for mistaking you for one of those leeches. So, what business have you here? This is a land of monstrosities, and I am no exception. You're here to save me. But I'm guilty. A wretched child of the abyss. Is that something you can forgive? Oh, really? You are no ordinary woman. Very well. Besides, I am Carla, and I.
Alright, so now that you've finished off her dialogue, she will warp to Firelink Shrine. So first, I'm gonna go ahead before I do anything and go to Firelink Shrine Bonfire. I got some tomes and some pyromancies to give to her. There are also a couple of dark sorceries that she will start out with right off the bat. So we're gonna go ahead and pay her the visit first. And she will be almost directly underneath Andre. Very easy to miss if you're not familiar with Firelink Shrine or if this is your first time for
There
the
he is.
game.
Now, the only thing that might interest you, although my dark arts are a detestable, that wouldn't interest
And of course, I wanna learn dark sorceries from
you.
her.
Make it very well. Some be kept. That There is one.
Alright, and now she starts out with, if you notice, a couple of dark sorceries. It's Dark Edge and also Affinity. Now, you can also give her pyromancy tomes for the Kulana pyromancy tome and a Grave Warden pyromancy tome. So let's go ahead and give those to her.
Oh, and I may be a thief.
And Divine Tomes. You can give her the Landor Divine Tome and the D. Braille Divine Tome. You gotta give her the D. Braille Divine Tome first before she accepts the Landor one. And now, as you can see, she's got a lot more spells at her disposal. So I'm gonna go ahead and just pick up Gnaw and Fire Whip. Report is actually a very fun pyromancy to use. This one charms the enemy and makes them a temporary ally. And this works on a lot of enemies, so you can actually have some fun with that. Capturing those Lothric Knights and the Cathedral Knights and making them fight other enemies. So it works well against a group of enemies where there is like one tough one, for example. When you get higher to the Castle of Lothric, that seems to work pretty well. Now, moving on, let's go ahead and travel to the Profane Capital and finish out this level. Okay, now, when you arrive here, if you remember in the last video, we taken the stairs down and explored the area around the Toxic Pond. Now we're gonna go ahead and climb down here, and we are actually gonna be exploring the walkway to the boss, and the boss of this area is Yorm the Giant. Do be careful, those jailers in white robes can actually hit you from a very far distance away. So watch out for their attacks. There's also going to be a gargoyle on the bridge. I usually just run past her. Don't really have to fight her at any moment right now. So I'm going to go ahead and make my way into this profaned capital area. There are going to be plenty of those jailers around us. And also a few gargoyles too. So... for my ring, I'm just gonna go ahead and swap on the Night Slayer ring. Although it's, I don't know how useful it will be at the moment. And the gargoyle will drop down. Okay, now that you've killed the gargoyle, you can go ahead and take out those jailers. There are three groups of jailers, one on the left, one on the right, and one kind of behind. They do have a bunch of fire attacks at their disposal, although they're not nearly as dangerous as the black jailers we fought earlier in the video. Now, when you've taken them out, let's go ahead on the other side and kill the jailers there. I'm gonna go ahead and switch off my Darkmoon Blades. I'm just worried that I'll get summoned right in the middle of the video here, although that wouldn't be too bad, since getting summoned for this covenant is a pain in the ass. And over here, there's another group of jailers. Do be careful, because there will be another gargoyle that will jump down, as you can see. So I'm just gonna go ahead and take out this pesky jailer first. I kinda wanna get rid of this gargoyle before I do anything with these jailers. Okay, now that I got them both down, there's a big group of jailers up ahead, and also there are a couple of mimic chests. That's right, both of those chests have mimics. And these guys are, as you can see, they're mighty annoying if you fight them in a group. They do aggro quite easily as well. Okay, and took some Estus. But I did bring him down. You can open this chest without any repercussions. This is a normal chest that contains ember. And over here, two mimic chests. Obviously, you don't want to aggro both of them at the same time, so I would suggest just concentrating on one of them. And hopefully you don't get eaten. Alright, now I got this sucker down. Let's go ahead and take out the other one. Usually I just try to hammer on those mimics as much as I can. And then I just run between their legs, so that should be fairly easy. And Great Shield of Glory. This one is actually a fairly decent Great Shield for all of those running with enough strength to wield those. It's not a bad option because it offers the highest stability, and although the elemental resistances aren't that great, it's still a shield that doesn't require a ridiculous amount of strength, and it has the best ability in the game. The weight is also less than that of a Havel Great Shield, so you might want to consider that as an option. Personally, I'm a fan of the Artorias Great Shield, which in this game I believe it's called Old Wolf Great Shield, for which you get for ranking up in the Watch Dogs of Faerun Covenant. So over here, just want to pick up a couple of items. Let's see what we've got going on. Just a couple of rusted coins. Okay, now I got most of the necessary stuff in the area. There is a... if you follow this drop, I believe there is something you can pick up on that ledge. Like, kind of underneath the bridge. So I might as well just go ahead and grab it, why not? This boss is not particularly challenging. It's another gimmicky boss, kind of like High Lord Volnir that we fought in the Catacombs of Karthus. Also, if you have any problems with these bosses, you can always summon for help as well. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and try to avoid the gargoyle. And let's see, Oni Slayer Greatbow. Sounds like it should be an Animusha game. Okay, so now moving on, I'm gonna go ahead and unequip my sword and shield, simply because there will be a weapon that you basically will have to use during this boss fight. It's gonna be Storm Ruler. And now when I'm gonna enter the fog, you will notice that I will get a cutscene with Sigward. And they sure did a great job of making Yorm look very menacing. He kind of reminds me of Old Hero, actually, and his fight kind of calls back to Demon Souls in that regard. So I'm gonna go ahead and flip on the Storm Ruler real quick. Sigward doesn't last too long if you don't grab it quick enough and start wailing on Yorm. you time your attacks right, now you gotta use weapon art for this fight. If you time your attacks right, you can just basically keep the boss stun locked. So you gotta use the weapon art, and you gotta wait for it to fill up. I think the camera is the biggest boss in this fight. And just like that he goes. So this is an extremely easy fight, and don't be fooled, there will be a top boss almost directly after this part. So I'm gonna go ahead and just flip my sword and shield back on at least. I gotta get rid of some of these weapons, they're just crowding the way at this point. And here he will give you another Siegbrow. Now, once you down the boss, talk to Sigward, and exhaust his dialogue, you will get this cutscene. And this cutscene informs you of the last boss, Prince, well, the last Lord of Syndra, I should say, not nearly the last boss. Prince Lothric, he is the final Lord of Syndra that you have to destroy. Okay, and looks like this priestess here is on her last breath, so go ahead and talk to her.
Lothric is in your hands. Please save his soul. Tell him what he must be, a lord.
And you will receive this basin of vows. Now, I'm not gonna place it quite yet. First, what I wanna do is warp back to the shrine bonfire. And I want to spend some of these souls before we continue, because there will be a boss fight coming up. And this one is a lot more challenging than the Yorm fight. So first things first, let's go ahead and place Yorm's soul where it belongs. And that's going to be the very first altar here. And just place his gigantic melon on there. Let's see, I think I got some umbral ash to give to the shrine handmaiden. And I could also level up a bit. I might just do that. Put some points in Int and Faith, since eventually I want to start making this build a Pyromancer. I just don't have... Well, I have enough stats, I just haven't really distributed them in a good manner for that. Simply because early on in the game, the best setup is probably just running Raw Astora Straight Sword up until the very end. So you can't go wrong with that. So first I'm going to go ahead and teleport to Yorm the Giant bonfire. And you haven't lit this fire, but it just appears there after you defeat Yorm. Okay. Okay, and over here you will notice there's an item available right in the middle of the room. This is actually Sigwart's armor and Stormruler and his shield. So now you have two Stormrulers at your disposal. And once we got that, I'm gonna go ahead and travel to the Wort of the Boreal Valley bonfire. And this is the shortest route to Dancer of the Boreal Valley boss fight, which will appear once you place the Basin of Vows. Okay, and as far as the rings that I'm gonna run for this fight, choices are kind of limited at the moment, so I really don't need to run anything outside of the three rings that I already have. I suppose I can just go with the Night Slayer ring. It's if anything, it's useful for these guys. Fucker hurt me. He's gonna pay for that. Okay, so I'm still rocking my Astoris straight sword plus 7. Okay, so these knights are a pushover compared to the beginning of the game. I can one-shot backstab them now. And I'm not gonna bother with the other two knights. I'm just gonna make a beeline straight for the boss fight. Okay, and once you place the Basin of Vows on the altar, you will get this cutscene where the dancer pops out from the top. Now, this boss is a lot more agile than the bosses that we fought previously, and also has a wider array of attacks at its disposal. It's a really cool cutscene, probably one of the better boss cutscenes in this game. I like how he, I guess she jumps out from up top. Looks like it could be she, so let's go with that. Not entirely sure. I haven't actually read the soul descriptions for this guy. And not off to a good start so far. Watch out for that grab attack. That will hit you for very good. There he gets me. So you'll see it for yourself. So over half of HP right there. And that almost killed me. Just kind of want to dodge through that attack. And once the dancer starts this weird looking dance, you just want to get as far away as possible. This will go on for a while, and if you get caught up in that combo, it will hit you for a lot of damage. and you kind of want to just stay behind it, but do not get caught up in the combo. Yeah, I'm flasking a little too much here. But there he goes. So that wasn't too bad, actually. Again, you know, as with some of these bigger bosses, camera can be a real bitch. But I kind of got lucky here. So I'm going to go ahead and light the bonfire. And this will actually be the end of the episode. I'm going to go ahead and place the basin here. And this will unlock the way leading up to the top of the Lawfrey Castle. And after the cutscene, you will get this ladder that will take you up top. So in the next portion, we're going to go and proceed to fight Osiris, the Consumed King. So first, I'm going to go ahead and teleport back to the Firelink Shrine. And let's go ahead and see if there are new items that we can purchase from Ludlev. So first things first, let's go ahead and talk to Ludlev, see if he's got anything new to say. I can get Soothing Sunlight from the Soul of the Dancer. I'm going to go ahead and pick that up. And let's see, I've basically picked up everything else. We can also level up or spend some of these souls on getting stuff from Carla. So I'll think about what I want to do with that, and I will see you guys in the next episode. Next up, as I mentioned, we're going to go ahead and proceed to fight Osiris the Consumed King and unlock the passageway to the Untamed Graves. Thank you very much for watching, and as always, have a great day.